December 10th marked the first of two visits to Maple Leaf Gardens of the Vancouver Canucks, and also marked the return to the garden.
Normal day, but when you add in the storm surge, take a look at what happened.
On that night, Williams produced one of the most memorable goals of this season, and he followed it with the Tiger Ride. Williams and the Canucks are back. The Tiger perhaps...
A CBET Sports Special. Exciting National Hockey League action featuring the Toronto Maple Leafs at home and on the road. Tonight's game is brought to you in part by Molson's, brewers of Molson Canadian Lager Beer.
The Vancouver Canucks are sitting in 11th place. That's where the Leafs finished last year. They'd like to think they can get there again. To that end, a victory tonight is important for the Leafs. Good evening, everyone. I'm Dave Hodge with the coach of the Vancouver Canucks, Harry Neal. And Harry, when you were here in early December, the first time this season, there was nothing but nice things to say about the Canucks. Then the calendar had to go and change, and it was a tough January, and I guess you can still talk about a Vancouver slump. Tell us what happened.
Well, we were 0 for February, and it wasn't even a leap year, so you can imagine what might have happened last year. But in my 3 years there, the same things happened at roughly the same time, and it happens to almost all our players. And I really don't know what the reason for such a drop-off in performance is. The only thing that I can say now is we've won two of our last four games and looked a lot more like the team that we in Vancouver enjoyed so much for the first 50 games.
And you have to be happy that as things have turned around slightly, Tiger Williams has come out of that slump. He was your leader when you were going well, and he has to be your leader the rest of the way.
Well, he can't do it alone, and there's been a few people who have been in the same kind of doldrums he's been in, but he's showing signs of coming around, too, and a night in Toronto might be just what he needs.
Thank you, Harry. Good luck to the Vancouver Canucks. Bill Hewitt will call the play-by-play with Brian McFarland at his side. Bob Goldham will be with me in the intermission for his highlights. We'll return to Maple Leaf Gardens in just a moment.
Have you ever seen
Maple Leaf Gardens in Toronto? We bring you the Vancouver Canucks and the Toronto Maple Leafs, and a big Eastern welcome to our Western viewers in British Columbia tonight. As the Vancouver Canucks begin a four-game road trip, they play here tonight. They're on Long Island on Saturday, Boston on Sunday, then on to Calgary for a Tuesday night game, then home for seven of their next 11 games at home. The Leafs are still looking for their first victory of the year against the Canucks. They're 0-2-1. Tiger Williams put on quite a show here last time. We've had a couple of shootouts between these two clubs, Bill, 8-5, and
that's
then again
right.
8-5, and then a 2-2 tie as things tightened up a bit. And I would think, Bill, that Tiger is primed tonight. He got such a roar of welcome last time he was here, and then he rode the hockey stick down the ice, regardless of splinters, and he's always a favorite here. He's got a big sign down at one end of the arena with just one large tiger printed on it. He's warming up and ready to go. So Tiger Williams returns to Maple Leaf Gardens. We have the Canucks and the Leafs ready to do battle here. It'll be Hanlon in goal. He's been often injured for the Vancouver Canucks, and Jim Rutherford returning after a bruised thumb for the Toronto Maple Leafs. So the players head for their benches. The officials are at center ice. The crowd is ready. So are we. Let's pause. Here's Paul Morris with the national anthem.
Ladies and gentlemen, please join Ralph Fraser at the organ and sing O Canada.
the officials for tonight's game. There they are at center ice. That's referee is Ron Wicks, and the linesmen are Ron Finn and Leon Stickle. In the net for Vancouver, Glenn Hanlon, average 4.57. And out the other end of Maple Leaf Gardens is Jimmy Rutherford, and he has an average of 4.99. And there's the referee, Ron Wicks, bringing the players to center ice to get this game underway. Starting off at center ice for Vancouver is number 20, Jerry Miner. He's out there with Jerry Butler and Darcy Rota. That's the forward line that starts the game for Vancouver. They have Derlego out there with John Anderson, number 10, and Pat Hickey, number 16. Vancouver, having possession, shoot the puck in offside as Jerry Miner couldn't get out in time.
You heard Harry Neal, the Vancouver coach, talk about the recent slump of the Canucks. Said he couldn't quite put his finger on the reasons for it. He says Tiger Williams can't do it all himself. Harry will be 44 next week. Earlier in the year, he says he's not trying to be coach of the year, just trying to be coach for this year.
Puck from the faceoff to Dave Farish, number 23, behind Robert Picard, number 4. It goes down the ice. Here's a race for it. And Hanlon knocked it off to the boards. At least try to keep it in and do. It comes back. There's a shot by Farish, and then Hanlon handled that. Back of the net for Kevin McCarthy. Got it up to center ice. McCarthy playing on the defense with number 2, Bob Mantle. Around it comes for Hickey. They go to the boards. Picard lost it. Now Lanz is out there, shot the puck to the other side, and the Leafs have to bring it out. Cleared by Derlego, and Lanz has it for Vancouver. It's cleared up to center ice, right back to the Leaf line, and they shoot it down the ice. That was Picard, and that could be icing, and it is.
Mike Nicolak coming off that 1-0 loss to the Kings the other night. Would like to get the Leafs rolling here again tonight. Incidentally, we should say hello to Charlie Simmer, who is in Wellesley Hospital tonight, recuperating from that badly broken leg suffered in the game against the Leafs here at Maple Leaf Gardens the other night. Charlie's lost now for several months. The Kings will miss him. Hockey will miss him. A great fella. And Charlie, if you're looking in tonight, we wish you a speedy recovery.
Rosser is now at center ice. There's a shot. That's wide. Comes back to the blue line, cleared by Lance right on the net, but it was intercepted by the Leaf players. Now it's Lance again coming in from the side all alone, and Rutherford stopped that hot shot. Darryl Sittler is out there with Paymo and Martin. Puck is cleared around to Terry Martin. Martin overskates the puck, gets it again, and he's hit hard into the boards by Stan Spiel. It's back up at center. Going back for Boya Selming. He missed Sittler with the pass. That's going over the red line. And it's back there to touch it as Lanz, and we have an icing. From Maple Leaf Gardens in Toronto, this is Bill Hewitt with Brian McFarland.
Parker Brothers Kawasaki, 3303 Walker Road.
Tiger Williams is out there now on the wing for the Vancouver Canucks. Face-off in deep Leaf territory.
Number 9, Ivan Buldarev, and that was Bobby Schmatz who fanned on the shot. It comes into the corner. Melrose is knocked to the boards by Williams, and the Leafs bring it out. It's shot by Ron Settlebauer, number 18, and the Canucks recover. Kevin McCarthy got the puck, and it's over here to Williams, going right in on goal, and that was stopped by Rutherford. Another shot, and that just went wide of the open net. Ron Settlebauer comes back for the Leafs, number 18, shoots it in. Hanlon drives it off the glass. Bruce Boudreau gets it back to the blue line. A pass in front of the net, And the Canuck with Bobby Schmatz, clearing it out to center ice. Harry Melrose. The backhand into Vancouver territory. After it is Boudreau. Saginaw took it, shot it back of the net. Settlebauer goes to Boudreau. Boudreau kicked it. Settlebauer again, then lost it. And back come the Canucks. That's Holderev trying to go through the defense. Covered up by Rutherford with Tiger Williams and Bobby Schmatz right there.
The Canucks trying to slide through there. Boldarev with the puck. Melrose takes him out of the play, bowls him over. Earlier, Williams had the first really good scoring chance when he drilled one at Rutherford, and Boldarev, following up on the play, almost slipped in the rebound.
At center ice, number 7, Gary Lupo. And from the faceoff, it's Picard. He was knocked down. The puck goes loose. The Leafs clear the puck down the ice. Going back for it is Rick Lenz. Lenz having it behind the net, missed a heavy check. Picked off then by Harold Snips. He shot the puck out the center ice. No score, first period. 16:44 remaining. Snips goes back for the puck into the corner. Shot it up on the wing, and it was steered out by Brent Ashton. Back there for it is Picard. Hit the back of the net. They're trying to get it out in front, and the Leafs get it. That's 5. Over to DeLego. Back to Dan Maloney. Let it fly. It ends up back of the net. It came out in front on the deflection. Here's a shot by Dan Maloney again. That just went wide. Snips getting it over on the wing and cleared out by Kurt Fraser. Now here the Canucks coming in again as Farish runs into Ashton. Puck slides back into offside into the Leafs zone.
Move to the taste of life.
Now the Leafs have had a close call at the other end of the ice as Hanlon had to be quick here. This play developed from behind the net. He couldn't quite snare that one, so DeLego brings it out in front and almost bounced in off the skate of the rookie defender, Rick Lands, who wears number 4, and he's going to be a very good one. Vancouver out shooting Toronto 3-2 to this point.
Miner, Rota, and Butler out there on the forward line for the Vancouver Canucks as the Leafs bring the puck in. A pass for Terry Martin was tipped. Hanlon came out of the net to get it. Dan Sittler couldn't keep it in. And coming quickly is Jerry Miner. He took a relay back, and then he's knocked down. Puck goes to Butler. Butler tried to feed Rota, and it came out to center ice. Goes back to Mano. Mano then tips it back to Lars Lindgren. And it's offside at the Vancouver blue line.
Three fine coaches assisting with the Vancouver Canucks. Of course, Harry Neal is the head man, then the assistants. Dave Dunn, a former Leaf on the left of your screen, and Tom Watt, who had a phenomenal record as coach of the University of Toronto Blues. There's Dunn's record, 74-76. Had a long chat with him before the game tonight about some of the young Leaf or young Vancouver defenders.
Rollo Brosser out there at center ice, number 16 for Vancouver. The puck back of the Canuck net goes over onto the far wing. Radin couldn't get it as the puck was shot. Brought back out over the blue line. Kamal comes right back in again. Number 99. He tried to send it out in front. It goes to the corner. Shot off the boards. Past Martin all the way down to Salming at center ice. He's being watched by Radin. Goes over to Juris. Slava Juris then lost the puck. Finally clears it out to Terry Martin. Martin to Pimo. Harold Snips trying to line him up. That shot was just wide. Goes back down the ice. A race for it. Gradine on the left wing. Picked up there by Brosser and then knocked back to Snips. Snips a long pass up here to Smeal. Smeal took a long shot into the corner. The rebound out in front. And that's Ian Turnbull, number 2. Taken to the boards and getting a whistle. This is NHL Hockey live from Maple Leaf Gardens in Toronto.
for the cold winter. A warm sheepskin or leather coat from Canadian Sheepskin and Leather Manufacturing. Choose from a varied selection of ladies and men's sheepskin and leather coats, car coats, jackets, and vests. We're also taking orders for ladies and men's extra large and tall sizes. For our American customers, we honor the daily bank rate on U.S. funds. Canadian Sheepskin and Leather Manufacturing Limited, the mark of quality with low prices. Two convenient locations, 974 Howard Avenue at Erie and 7631 Tecumseh Road East.
Still scoreless early in the first period here at the Gardens, Vancouver and Toronto.
Goldarev with Schmatz and Williams has a shot from the blue line. Rutherford handled, shot it into the corner. Puck goes over to Saganek, number seven. He gets it ahead to Boudreaux. Boudreaux goes over the line, trying to cut around Lindgren, and he was rammed into the boards. Puck cleared by Boldarev over to Williams. Williams then gives it back to Lindgren. Lindgren gets over the line, trying to hit Boldarev, and the puck ends up in the corner. Melrose, then Boudreaux's there as he lost his helmet.
That helmet's way back down the other end of the ice, Bruce, if you're looking for it. Meanwhile, the Leafs are playing a bumping game to start off tonight, and there's Glenn Hanlon shoveling the helmet down the ice to Boudreaux. But, Bill, I don't know whether you agree with me, but Hanlon looks a little bit shaky in the first few minutes here tonight, a little hesitant in clearing the puck. He's let one or two drop out of his glove, and, of course, he's missed a lot of action through injury, not only this year but last. Glenn Hanlon, a fine young netminder.
All set to go. Bruce Boudreaux against Boldarev, and at least win the draw. Puck is cleared to the blue line. Shot right back by Mano. It's back of the net, and the Leafs recover again. Bruce Boudreaux clearing it, but not out. Mano kept it in. Here's Red for the Boldarev. She scores! Ivan Boldarev, number nine.
600th career point, and the Vancouver Canucks take an early lead here. Boldarev, the much-traveled veteran, drills one past Rutherford to get the Canucks off to a good start here in the early going. That was a fine pass from Mano, number two, shoveled it over to Boldarev, and he caught the corner with the shot. Ivan Boldarev. Is 26.
6:33.
And the time, 6:33.
From Bob Mano, time 6:33.
Oh, Vancouver goes up 1-0 here in the first period. Harold Snips clearing it up along the boards. It's out to center ice. Miner gets it over out to Rota. Rota tries to find Miner, does, number 20. He clears it. There's the backhand by Butler. And now then the Leafs shoot the puck out this time and down the ice. Going back for it is Kevin McCarthy, number 25. Out there on the defense with Harold Snips. McCarthy chased back of the net. Derligo is out in front. Snips gets it up to the blue line. It was shot right back into the corner. Miner shoots it around on this side for Jerry Butler. Butler makes sure of it this time by clearing it down the ice. Dave Farish goes back. 1-0 Vancouver. 12:29 to go in the first period. Long pass to Pat Hickey, to John Anderson. Back to Hickey, back to Anderson. He's over the line to Picard. Picard is dumped. There's a shot right on. And it's broken up. Miner shoots it out for Rota. And Farish goes back for it. Over to Picard. Picard hit a skate. Now it's Darryl Sittler with Farish. Pass up to the blue line. And a relay from Paymon to Sittler didn't work. Paymon has to go back. Right up by Slava Juris. He shot it. It bounces high and goes into the crowd. This is the Vancouver Canucks and the Toronto Maple Leafs.
Windsor Electric and Fireplace Gallery has all the latest products to help you save energy. Quality glass doors for the fireplace help keep furnace-generated heat in the house. Heat-producing inserts can drastically cut your present fuel bill. Wood stoves capable of heating your entire home, and Bocam quartz energy saving heaters. Come in and see our outstanding selection at Windsor Electric and Fireplace Gallery, where we make living in the 80s easier by using less energy.
live here at Maple Leaf Gardens and preparing for a face-off that Sittler wins, but it goes all the way back to Borja Salming deep in Leaf territory. Back of the net for Salming over to Juris, up to Martin. Then for Sittler, who tried to get it over to Pima, then the Canucks break that up. Neal went after it. Leafs get it, shoot it back. Lands took his man out. Lands flipped it to center ice. Shot over the line by Brasser. They go to the boards. Trying to get the puck loose, they can't, and it's finally whistled down by Ron Wicks, the referee.
Bill, that gives us a chance perhaps to look at that goal once again by Ivan Boldarev, the 32-year-old veteran, but there's the setup we talked about. Mano just a needle getting that puck right over to Boldarev and perfectly onto the stick, and then the shot to the corner. 26 of the year.
Juris back of the net. A pass over on, goes up to center ice, stopped by Lands. Lands of Vancouver then hit Juris. Juris in possession, goes to Borja Salming. Salming to Juris. A pass over for Sittler. Lands goes to the corner, Sittler after him. Puck comes loose, right out in front, Pima shoots. Cannon stop there, scores on the rebound.
Came off for balance to get the puck on the rebound as Hamlin came well out of the goal crease trying to smother the first shot, and he did that well. There's Hamlin, but the rebound slipped away. You could see Hamlin trying to get it with his stick, and he almost did. He fought gallantly to prevent that one from going in, but Pima outmaneuvered him, and we're tied at one. Gary Martin gets one assist, and Sittler gets the other. 9:20 the time.
From Gary Martin and Darryl Sittler, time 9:20.
So we have a 1-1 tie with 10 minutes, 37 seconds remaining in the first period. Back there is Bob Mano, number two. He went down. The Leafs recover the puck. And Rick Vive couldn't get a shot. There they go. The Leafs boost Boudreaux for Vive. Centering it out. Cleared over to Bobby Schmatz. Schmatz at center ice. Goes over the line. Williams is bumped by Ian Turnbull. And that, of course, is an offside.
Well, you can't fault Hanlon on that score because he got very little help. He makes the first stop. Pema gets around him and then through traffic finds a little bit of an opening and slips it home. Pema, goal number 31 from Martin and Sittler at 9:20.
So it's Bruce Boudreaux, number 11 at center ice, with Maloney on one wing, Vive on the other. Here's a pass to Maloney. Maloney going down the ice. He overskates the puck, and it's offside. With the score, Vancouver 1, Toronto 1. Our telecast returns in a moment.
Everyone has a best friend, and at Living Things, your best friend is waiting for you. At Living Things, there's a wide selection of pets. Puppies, cats, hamsters, birds large and small, and hundreds of fish. They all want to be your special friend. The experts there will help you select a pet and give you advice on how to care for it. Visit Living Things in the Malden Village Mall, Windsor, or the Chatham Place Mall in Chatham.
Harry Neal left, Mike Nikolak right. We played half a period and we're tied at one.
Boldarev at center, Williams and Schmatz on the wings. Shot back. That's Mano after it. Number two is up there on the defense with Kevin McCarthy. Puck is cleared just all the way down to Turnbull. Turnbull gets it back to Dan Maloney as Boudreaux fell over Vive. Mano back of the net with Boldarev, takes the pass. Boldarev coming up at center. A quick pass over here on the right side. And it's Tiger Williams trying to get in. He's bumped along the boards. Play is called, and we'll have a whistle.
In Toronto tonight, they're holding a candlelight vigil of hope at City Hall to honor 22-year-old Terry Fox, who inspired Canadians everywhere to raise $22 million for cancer research. And there he is wearing Darryl Sittler's All-Star sweater when he ran through Toronto last summer. And since then, Darryl and Terry become fast friends.
Goldarev, number nine, ready to face off against Boudreau. Boudreau wins the draw and also brings it out. A quick pass for Rick Five on the right side. Play is called. And we'll have penalties. Live from Maple Leaf Gardens in Toronto.
Williams having a good chat with the men in the penalty box. He and Maloney go off for roughing penalties. 10:39. Tiger only has about 4 minutes to go now to top the 2,000 penalty minute mark for his career.
So we have the teams playing five aside. Over there is Lindgren, number three with the puck, goes to Harold Snepps. Snepps tried to get it to Gradin, and the Leafs come back. Here's Darryl Sittler over the blue line. Got it for Paimon. Snepps knocked it along the boards. And Vancouver. Snepps getting it handed to him. Straight down the ice alone. Takes his shot and it's deflected into the corner. Going after it was Brosser. And that was intercepted. And here comes Borja Salming over the line. Sittler wouldn't wait long enough or couldn't wait long enough, and it was offside.
Hanlon feels the puck as we look at number 23, Thomas Gradin, 44 assists this year. We'll take a look at that shot. Watch Hanlon's right hand, the glove hand, and he snares that and looks up at it as it pops out of his glove.
Juris over to Salming, back for Sittler. Broken up. Kevin McCarthy getting it into the corner. Now it's picked off there by Brosser. Coming over the line, the Canucks move in. A pass, and that was broken up by Lavajuris to Borja Salming. Ahead to Paimon. Paimon getting into the clear. Going right in on goal. The rebound. And Sittler couldn't get it. It's cleared back out to center. On the ice. Or Brosser, and he was checked. It's cleared to the far wing where Rick lands, number four. Headmans the puck. Mano shooting it in and then racing over to the bench. Long shot to center ice. Lance stopped that. Jerry Butler going back in his own territory, all the way back of the net. Goes to Harold Snepps. Snepps. A pass for Butler is going down the ice. It goes over the red line. Touched by Picard, and that's icing.
Paimon tried to find an opening for his second goal of the game a few moments ago, and Hanlon closed the door on him very nicely, too. Paimon takes the good pass, breaks in now around the defender. Now watch the move on the goalie. Paimon looks up. He said, well, there should be a little bit of an opening here somewhere, but Hanlon says, no, there isn't. Fooled you.
Seven minutes, 28 seconds left in the first period, a 1-1 tie. Snaps. Elects to go to Butler. Butler backhands the puck out, and coming down the ice is Jerry Miner. Miner takes his shot, Rutherford knocked down, didn't see it, and that one stopped at the blue line. There's a try, Rutherford stopped that as Williams came awfully close. Now it's out in front, finally knocked out over the blue line. DeLego was checked, but Picard comes up. Missed the check from Williams. A long shot. And Harold snaps for Jerry Butler. Miner didn't see it, but he knocked his man down anyway, pins him against the boards, and there's no further play.
Well, Bill, the Leafs were very fortunate not to get behind by another goal as Rutherford lost sight of the puck.
With 6 minutes, 48 seconds left to play in the first period, the score of Vancouver 1, Toronto 1.
Pro Speed and Custom, experts in car, van, and four-wheel drive dress-up, has the custom accessories to enhance your vehicle's appearance. With a wide selection of rear window louvers, running boards for pickups and vans, flares, spoilers, bay windows, vents, roll bars, and mag wheels, for a truly distinguished vehicle you'll drive with a sense of pride. For the smooth ride you deserve, check out the quality radial tires, computer tire balancing available. Pro Speed and Custom, your car, van, and four-wheel drive dress-up center, with two convenient locations to serve you.
Jerry Miner is in the penalty box, and he's one of the ace penalty killers for the Canucks for a rarely called boarding penalty. Board checking at 13-12.
Rosser and Williams out on the forward line. McCarthy and Snaps out of the defense. And the Leafs bring the puck to center ice. It's Turnbull clearing it over on the right side. Cleared the rest of the way by Sittler. Hanlon shoots on the board. Settlebauer trying to get it loose. It's shot and it goes into the timer's box.
Former Leaf Jerry Butler, who went to the Canucks in the famous trade Butler and Williams for Derlego and Vive. That happened on Long Island, and it was Tiger Williams who told Butler he was moving on to Vancouver, and Butler for a while didn't believe him.
So Leafs have Sittler with Ron Settlebauer. Puck in the circle. Wilf Paimon is out on the right side. Pass back to Selming. Selming moves through center ice. Knocked it. Hanlon stopped it. Steps off the boards. Paimon couldn't get to it. And it's cleared out and down the ice. Leafs with a man advantage. Loria Salming in his own zone. Williams out there to try and kill off this penalty, along with Rosser. Here's Salming bringing it into the corner, but it was offside.
Well, it's interesting to see a young defenseman develop, and Kevin McCarthy, drafted originally by Philadelphia and then obtained, fortunately, I believe, by the Canucks, had 14 goals last year, or has 14 goals this year, had 15 last year, so he should top that mark. Said the turning point of his career probably was the day they named him captain. He has additional responsibilities. Very mature young fellow.
Puck is cleared by Vancouver down the ice. Leafs have to go back for it. Farish. There's 56 seconds left in the penalty. 5:42 to go in this first period and counting. Picard up to center ice. A pass from Maloney, and that was broken up. They go to the boards, try to freeze it there, and they do.
5:28 to play. We're going to show you an interesting photo of a couple of kids now. On the left is Danny Nikoluk. On the right is Mike Nikoluk, wearing some pretty fancy wide
lapels
in their suits there. But that's when they were young and growing up in Scarborough, Ontario. Danny went on to play with the Toronto Argonauts. They retired his jersey, and Mike went on to play professional hockey with the Leafs and in Hershey. They retired his jersey in Hershey, and they'll be with us in the intermission, or Danny will at least.
A pass up to Picard. Picard knocked over the line to Delego, and Delego was stopped by Smith before he got a shot. Hanlon gloves the puck, and they do a little pushing and shoving around that net.
Never seen so many guys in one little goal crease. Hanlon wisely steps aside because he's been the victim of several goal mouth collisions in his short career in the NHL. Each time they've been costly. Here's how it started. And they barge in to take five. 3-0 over Hartford, the shutout.
Kevin McCarthy and Harold Snips. Rollo Brosser set to face off against Bill Derlego. 5:17 remaining in the period. Picard took a shot and hit a leg. Now then, Dan Maloney gets it over to Picard again, a shot. That's wide. Maloney goes to the corner again, knocks Butler down, gets it to DeLego. DeLego right out in front. Back to the blue line. Ferris faked the shot, made a pass, and Busser intercepts. Killing off seconds with only two left to Jerry Butler, a backhand, and Rutherford stopped that. Now it's Dan Maloney getting it up on the wing to Vibes DeLego. DeLego tried to go through the defense, ends up in the corner, and Williams has it. Tiger Williams, number 22. And he... Mano for Williams. He was knocked down. Comes up to Turnbull. Turnbull with 4:22 remaining. Goes over the blue line with Terry Martin into the corner. Bruce Boudreau after it. He stole the puck. Tried to get it out in front of the net. And Schmatz will bring it back. Abby Schmatz getting it ahead. There's going to be a hooking penalty there as Williams was hooked.
Turnbull hooked Williams just as he tried to accept the pass from Schmatz and sail in over the Leaf blue line. The Canucks killed off the penalty time to Jerry Miner. The Leafs have not been very potent on the power play of late. They're 0 for 13 now. Now watch the pass come up to Williams, and just as he takes it on his stick, Turnbull hooks it.
Turnbull for hooking. 9:15:57. 1-1 tie. 4:03 remaining in the first period. Holderev at center. Getting set to go. Schmatz is the extra forward, number 8. And they're all playing well up inside the Leaf blue line. In front of the faceoff is cleared by Salming, and it goes down the ice. Rick Lands, number 4, is also out there. Schmatz has the puck. Bobby Schmatz picking his way out. Cleared it up at center ice to Boldarev. Boldarev tried to get Smeal loose on the right side. Dan Williams tried to get it out in front. Lance will try it again. Lance is checked by Pamel, and it's Martin. A quick pass to Pamel, and he lost it. Boldarev turning in his own territory to Schmatz. Too far for Lance, and the Leafs have recovered the puck. Pamel. A pass to Terry Martin into Pamel. He's going right in a goal. Handles that there. Right by the open net. Back for Boldarev. Over the line. Boldarev closing in. Stopped by Salming. To Pamel. Up the ice. A pass for Hickey. That failed to click. Boldarev comes back. And he hit Williams on the skate. Boldarev again at center. To the Leaf line. Gets around Juris. The shot is deflected wide. Williams can't get anywhere. Salming has it. And he gets it out over the line, and there's 32 seconds left in the penalty to Ian Turnbull.
Already in this shorthanded situation, the Leafs have had a couple of good scoring chances. The Canucks getting caught deep in the Leaf zone. Martin and Pema teamed up on one of them. Heads up play here. And again, Pema in this period has really shown some second effort here. He scored a goal with second effort earlier, and this one just slipped by the goalpost. Pema already has 3 shorthanded goals for this season. Jerry Miner of the Canucks has 4.
Puck comes back to the blue line, a shot right in front. There's a backhand, and that drive by Rota was smothered by Jimmy Rutherford.
Game number 27 of the year for Jimmy Rutherford.
Score is tied, 1-1.
There's the shot through the legs of Picard and right into the pads of Rutherford.
Rosser facing off. Kurt Fraser, number 24, is out there. Darcy Rota. Comes back to Brasser. Brasser's drive was shot, knocked down. Farish knocked another one down. And Sittler had it taken away by Brasser. Gradin missed it. It comes back to Brasser, though. Brasser gets set for the screen shot. It's right in front of the net. Back to the blue line. Another shot is wide. Vancouver putting on some pressure now. Turnbull is back out on the ice. Picard took his man down. The puck comes loose. It's back of the net. They're trying to get out in front. Here's a backhand, and that was shot wide. Now it's Pat Hickey just shooting it down the ice. That's going over the red line, and it'll be brought back for icing as the Leafs were even with the Vancouver Canucks.
Along with Danny Nikoluk in the first intermission, Dave Hodge will be chatting with Bobby Schmotz, the veteran player. He had a couple of good seasons with the Canucks a few years ago. 38 goals is top there, and of course, he's Don Cherry's best friend.
Jerry Miner back out at center ice for the Vancouver Canucks, and the Leafs shoot the puck in. Settlebauer out there with Boudreau and Saganuk. Cleared around on the board. Juris shooting it back. Saganuk is there. Saganuk tried to get loose. Ashton couldn't get anywhere. Now it's number three, Lars Lindgren. Puck goes back to center ice. Settlebauer, a backhand into the corner. Bob Mano goes after that. Bob Mano is stopped by Boudreau, but the puck slides as Settlebauer steps into his check. Then Boudreau knocked Mano down, play is called, and we get a whistle.
Ron Settlebauer, a former Canuck, 5 years out there, 74-79. I talked about Schmott scoring 38 goals. That was the Vancouver club record until Settlebauer chipped in with 40 in 1 year out there. Five goals in five games as a Toronto Maple Leaf.
Darryl Sittler with Wilf Paymaugh, Terry Martin. Puck back to Turnbull. Turnbull shot it and it went over the glass into the exit.
Down to 50 seconds on the clock. First period tied at one. Boldarev opened the scoring from Mano at 6:33. Then Paymaugh collected goal number 31 from Martin and Sittler at 9:20 of this first period.
Williams out there now, as is cleared by Ian Turnbull. Kevin McCarthy, number 25, to Harold Snepps, Williams. And it's cleared by Boldarev the rest of the way. Cleared by Rutherford, then out to center ice. Boldarev getting it to Bobby Schmotz, number 8. For Williams, but Williams was offside at the Maple Leaf blue line. 28 seconds remaining, first period.
Well, we've got a favorite character here at Maple Leaf Gardens. Pops, one of the vendors. There he is, 85 years young. And when Tiger Williams came in today, he awarded Pops a brand new Vancouver Canucks sweater, which he's proudly wearing under that blazer of his. So Pops is the happiest guy in the gardens tonight and Tiger's biggest fan.
Turnbull, a long pass intended for Paymaugh. That's going down the ice. Harold Snepps is going back to get it. Has possession, shoots it off the boards. Williams gets it the rest of the way to Boldarev. Boldarev, stick handles over the line. Williams is offside again on that left wing.
Just a postscript to that story on Popsville. Tiger Williams said to Pops before the game, if I score a goal tonight, Pops, I'm gonna give you $100.
On the faceoff, it's Ian Turnbull with 4 seconds left, shooting it down the ice. Easily handled by Glenn Hanlon. The bell goes and the first period is over. And the teams prepare to leave for the dressing room. So the score at the end of the first period is Vancouver 1, Toronto 1.
Sunday afternoon, all their opponents will be
there's something naturally pleasing about us at Wubs. For that change of pace, come on in and try our fresh salad bar. Wubs Salad Bar offers a choice of 18 items, including fresh green peppers, sliced mushrooms, and that something extra, fruit cocktail. Top it all off with your favorite dressing and enjoy a delicious light meal. Get fresh at Wubs.
The Canucks, who had shot the Leafs 14-12, opened the scoring. Ivan Bolder, at 26th of the season, and then Will Fehmarn tied it, ending a scoreless streak of five consecutive periods for the Maple Leafs. It was Will Fehmarn's 31st of the season. 1-1 at the end of one, and with me is Bobby Schmatz of the Canucks, tied for Vancouver's scoring lead with Thomas Gradin. I would call you comeback player of the year, except I'm not sure you think you've been anywhere to come back from.
Well, I moved around an awful lot in the last year and a half, but I'm very happy to be back in Vancouver.
Tell us about maybe an old story for our Vancouver viewers, but it's one that Don Cherry likes to tell. The Boston training camp, the success you had there, and then the problems you had sticking with the Bruins and finally ending up in Vancouver.
Well, with the trouble, it started with Fred Creighton and myself, and then it was just a matter of I was gone. I ended up with Cherry back in Colorado, and then at the end of the year, I was a free agent. Talked to Harrison, and he said, come back to Boston, show me you can still play, and there'd be no problem in offering you a contract. First seven games, I had six goals. I was leading the club in scoring. He called me in Thursday, says, got some bad news for you, not offering you a contract, but that's it. I'll drop the equalization for you. You're free to make your own deal. And within a couple hours, I was on my way to Vancouver.
Now, why Vancouver? Because I understand there were some places you weren't interested in playing.
Well, I think it was mainly because I think I was ready to retire. I said maybe that was time for me to retire. I gave it a good shot at training camp, and it didn't seem to do anything for me. And I thought, well, okay, that may be it. And I still own my home in Vancouver, and my wife and kids have always liked it. So I thought that's maybe where we'd retire. But things worked out great for me, and I'm glad to be back in Vancouver.
Well, have they worked out great enough so that retirement is not on your mind?
I hope so. Like I say, it'll depend on what the last 15 games go and how playoffs go and whether or not Vancouver feels they can offer me a contract again. It'll be up to them.
Do you get the feeling that contracts, jobs in the NHL are becoming tougher for, I won't say old players, because I won't consider you old. If I do, then I'm in the same shape. But with more 18 and 19-year-olds playing now than ever before, does a guy start to get older quicker in terms of the way management looks at it?
I think so. I think anybody over the age of 27, now 28, they're considered old players. So, and just seeing that I'm over that, I must be considered very old. I mean, they call me fossil, so I must be. But I feel you should be rated on what you perform like and treated equally on that. But I can see where they want to go with the younger players, and they're drafting so young now that they have to put them in. It's no good for them to be down in the farm club, and I think that's causing why the age maybe is dropping so much.
Well, your success will cause some people to take a second look at players in their mid-30s, and it has, of course, delighted Don Cherry and many other people, most of them in Vancouver. Thanks, Bobby.
Thank you very much.
Bob Schmatz tied with Thomas Gradin for the scoring lead in Vancouver. Coming up next, the coach's brother, Danny Nikoluk, as the Canucks and the Leafs are tied 1-1. Our intermission continues in a moment.
12 million North Americans own waterbeds.
This is my bedroom.
A halcyon waterbed.
This is my bedroom.
A halcyon waterbed.
This is my bedroom.
Halcyon waterbeds. Visit a waterbed store, see the dozens of new waterbed designs, and try the astonishing comfort of a water mattress. From the most respected waterbed maker, Halcyon.
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 Give your retirement years new vitality and contentment. Come live here at Central Park Lodge. Enjoy new independence and security in a bright, spacious, and friendly environment. At Central Park Lodge, your daily rate includes an attractive furnished room or suite, all meals and snacks, social activities, and full personal attention by a caring staff. There's a hair salon, a tuck shop, laundry service, and much more. For the very heart of retirement living, Central Park Lodge in Windsor.
You are looking at a car of outstanding quality and efficiency. Chrysler Cordoba for 1981. Efficiently proportioned yet lavish in its quality of detailing, its interior comfort, its finely tuned ride. Fuel efficient too. Cordoba is rated an impressive 34 miles per gallon on the highway. Chrysler Cordoba, with the proven durability of a slant six engine. You asked for quality. Chrysler is engineering it.
Boldarev for the Canucks and Pema for the Maple Leafs. A 1-1 tie exists at the end of one period of play. And with me in this first intermission is Danny Nicolic, who used to be the most famous member of the family in Toronto. It has changed somewhat now since brother Mike has taken over the head coaching job of the Maple Leafs. How is it that you were steered to football and your brother played hockey?
Well, I think when we were younger, Dave, that probably I might have been the better hockey player and he was the better football player, but maybe I got a little too big for hockey, and I think he was probably a better competitor, better all-around athlete than I was.
You, of course, wore the Argo uniform longer than anybody else in history. You both smoked cigars, too. Now, that was, is that coincidence, or?
I think probably I might have started that.
You did.
When I never smoked until I started to play pro football, and then a couple guys with the Argonauts put me on cigars, and then probably I put Mike on them.
He, when he took the job, he was called Dan a lot because people had been used to addressing the Nicolic in Toronto. Do you get Mike now?
Not really. I used to get that from Bobby Clark
when
he was with Philadelphia, but I don't get that from many people. But a lot of people mistake me for Mike. And I remember one game here, I was walking up down the corridor, and a little kid came up to me and said, "Can I have your autograph?" And I said, "I'm not the coach of the Maple Leafs." He said, "Well, you sure look like him." And I said, "What would I be doing out here in the corridor?"
Well, what are you doing out there? Now, let's tell the people, you have trouble watching this game. You get nervous.
Well, yeah. I watched it till it was 1-0. You can't say I had trouble watching the game. Till Vancouver scored, I watched it. Then I have to go patrol my beat.
Uh-huh.
And I feel better when I'm walking around. I find it very tough to sit down and watch it. I like games when they're winning about 9-1 with 1 minute to play. Then I can really enjoy them.
Root them home, eh?
Yeah.
How has the job, as you see it, changed Mike, if at all?
I don't think it's changed Mike. He never talks hockey. He comes out to the place quite a bit, but he never really talks hockey. But he's the same old person that he was before. I don't think he's changed his personality, and he's just the same person. And I think the players believe in him, and he's truthful and tells them things that are true, and they believe that.
He stays the same, and your nerves get frayed. I guess
my
that's
nerves
a pretty
get
good
bad.
He's
nothing wrong with him at all.
Dan, thanks for being with us. I'm sure the fans have enjoyed hearing you, and we'll be back with Bob Goldham as our intermission continues with highlights in just a moment.
I'm about to show you something that you've wanted for a long time, the perfect haircut. At Superclips, we have developed a unique haircutting technique that guarantees a perfect, no mistake, no hassle, wash and wear haircut every time. Our Superclippers are fully licensed professionals who cut your hair the way you want at affordable Superclip prices. Just walk in, no appointments necessary ever. At Superclips, we can cut it.
Evening, Mr. Conrad. Anything good on?
Huh?
Can't help but notice your chair. Sharp.
Oh, yeah, thanks.
Is it Canadian?
Canadian?
Well, when you shop Canadian, you get more than you paid for. You get comparable quality and workmanship, you buy jobs for Canadians, and a better economy.
Gee, I'll buy that. Hope that's Canadian, dear.
When you shop Canadian, it's good for everyone.
We'll buy that.
North America's only six-passenger front-wheel drive wagon
is a Chrysler K car.
Named Motor Trend's Car of the Year. Heads up.
Best gas economy of any six hockey player car.
Front-wheel drive Dodge Aries K and Plymouth Reliant K give you the highest gas economy, lowest prices in six-passenger two-doors, four-doors, and wagons. Drive Motor Trend's Car of the Year.
There's room for you in a K car. What team did you say you're with?
Do you take your photos like this or like this? You're looking at the very latest Soligor zoom lenses. They're good quality, priced reasonably, and fit any SLR 35mm camera. The professionals at Frank Wansbrough's Camera Shop can help you if you're serious about photography. They'll sell you the right kind of camera and accessories for your type of picture taking. Wansbrough's experts also take the time to show you the right way to use the equipment they sell you. If you take your photos seriously, then come and see the people at Frank Wansbrough's Camera Shop.
You're enjoying TV9 Windsor, your station for Super Sports and Maple Leaf Hockey.
But after one period, the Canucks and the Maple Leafs, and we have time for some highlights from Bob Golden, beginning with the goals as they occurred. The first one by Ivan Boulder, a nifty little pass from Bob Mano.
Well, we try to be objective about this, Dave, and there's a lesson to be learned here. And, you know, you learn this very young. You don't try to pass or bring the puck up through center if you can get away with it. Rocky Saginaw made that mistake. He's in good control right here as the play develops. Not really being checked too closely, but he takes this time right now to try to put a little dump pass through center, but a pretty good save by the Vancouver defenseman right at that point, and a nice little dump pass. But watch Boulder if he goes right to Rutherford's strength, right to his catching hand, and he beat him on the short side rather. But the save at the blue line was the point, the fact that you shouldn't try to take that puck up through center if you can help it.
I think
it.
We better absolve Saginuk of the blame. It wasn't him. I believe it might have been Boudreau, but it was a
left-hand. Well, whoever it was, okay. He shouldn't have been coming up through center. If it wasn't Rocky, I'm sorry, Rocky.
Now, okay. The goal by Wilf Paymo.
Right. This resulted in a little bit of what I think Nikolak's trying to get his club to do, put two men in deep on the forechecking, and we see it. It's cleared in here on an attempted pass to Sittler coming up the left side. The puck gets loose, and Vancouver defenseman is in tight on the puck right here. Sittler right behind him. I think it's Lance that he's checking. Well, Sittler takes the man and lets the puck loose. Martin back out to a wide open Paymon in front. A great save by Hanlon. You know, you can't fault him. And a pretty good shot right here by Paymon, too, because he didn't have much room to put that in. But I think the key to that play was the fact that there was two Leafs in and tight on a loose puck.
Paymon's 31st goal of the season. He had an excellent chance later on to get number...
On his 32. Offside. And here again, there is something to be learned by this, Dave, when your defense are playing up to gambling a little bit, too. The pass, the lead pass here by Salming was just, you know, a super pass. He couldn't have laid it in there any better as he dumps it up here on his forehand to Paymon, as I said, on his off wing. But you see where McCarthy was at that time. He was gambling a long way up. But when he goes in on Hanlon doesn't give him a darn thing to shoot at. He didn't give him short side. He didn't give him through the legs. He didn't give him long side. He made a nice save. But like I said first, if you play up, you gamble. If you don't have that wing coming back to help you out.
Thank you, Bob. After one period of play, then, Vancouver 1 and Toronto 1.
We are the...
Car dealers with the big deals are none other than Essex Auto Sales and Jim Allen Chevolts Limited. For dependable General Motors transportation, visit the little car dealers in Essex. For Pontiac Buick, it's Essex Auto Sales. For Chevolts, it's Jim Allen Chevolts Limited. Visit the little car dealers today.
Little car dealer.
People all across Canada get the money's worth at Sears. Cause you can rely on what you buy at Sears. You get your money's worth and more.
Well, at Sears, the prices are really great. And as far as merchandise goes, everything I've ever bought there has been really good quality. I get my money's worth at Sears.
Cause Sears believes in value. And you believe in Sears because you get your money's worth. Your money's worth and more.
Vancouver Canucks struggling on the road of late. Winless in their last 9 road games. They're tied at 1 with the Leafs here at Maple Leaf Gardens.
And we'll have the Phillips first period summary for you. There you see it, Boldarev's 26th at 6:33, Paymon's 31st at 9:20. Shots, Vancouver 14, Toronto 12.
Teams are back on the ice. Just run down that Vancouver Canuck lineup.
Two teams are really playing it pretty tight, Brian, in that first period.
Well, they're both bumping pretty well, too. They've obviously had instructions to play the man. Of course, Harry Neal will tell you, we don't have a team of superstars. We have fellas who have to work hard, grind it out, finish the check, and hope for the breaks at times.
I also noticed that it's a type of first period where there is a little bit of hitting, and it's hard hitting, but it's not chippy. And it's not dirty.
Right. Tiger Williams, of course, all eyes on Tiger, number 22. Every time he plays here at Maple Leaf Gardens.
Well,
March 11th, a reminder that it'll be Boston at Toronto. That'll be for Ontario and viewers in British Columbia as well. That'll be a 5 p.m. start in British Columbia. Boston at Toronto, March 11th. A little repair work. Hi. Superstar of the future. Kids in the block don't want to tangle with him. A little repair work off the right goalpost behind Hanlon. Talking with Dale Tallon, who was once the number one draft choice of the Vancouver Canucks. There he is in our radio broadcast booth right behind us with Ron Hewitt.
And we're all set to go now with Gary Miner at center, Butler and Darcy Rota on the wings. Leafs have the puck up at center. Hickey sends it over. John Anderson, who was used rather sparingly in the first period, cleared it around on the boards. Rota jammed there, and Derlego, and they get a whistle. Darcy Rota, number 18.
Bill, let's take a quick look at the scoreboard. Edmonton and the Rangers tied at one there in the second period. Quebec leading Washington 2-1 also in the second. Los Angeles leading Pittsburgh 3-2 second period score. Calgary and Buffalo scoreless in the second.
Play underway as Bob Mano shoots the puck for Miner. Stopped at center ice by Picard. Cleared the rest away by Derlego. Only to have Rota get it up to Miner. Miner comes in for Vancouver. Taken out by Dave Farish. Comes back to Mano at the blue line. He gave it away to Derlego. Derlego straight up at center, over the line. Hickey shoots, and Hanlon stopped that. Now Miner will try it again for Vancouver. Down the right wing, Derlego after him. Flips the puck in, and the next make a change. That's Snaps going back for it along with Lanz, and that's icing called against the Maple Leafs.
At least trying to catch the Canucks on a line change there. It gives us another chance to look or run down the other scores in the NHL tonight. Montreal having no trouble against the Winnipeg Jets, leading 5-0 now. LaRouche, LaFleur, Napier, Lambert, and Gainey. And the second pair, Detroit leading Chicago 1-0. Goal by Mark Curtin, the former Leaf. And Boston, Minnesota, scoreless. Look out for trouble there. They're in the first period.
Brosser on the forward line now as Sniffs lets the shot go. Trying to get a hold of it. Brosser. Brosser in against the boards. And they get a whistle.
I say watch out for trouble in Minnesota tonight, Bill, because Boston and the North Stars had quite a rumble last time they met. And I'm just wondering what's keeping John Ziegler from meting out punishment for some of these fellas that have been involved in these Donnybrooks, and especially the Rangers going into the stands in Detroit. It's been long overdue, a decision of some sort.
We have Smeal on the right side, Gradin on the left, as the puck goes to center ice. Canucks shoot the puck right in again. And Terry Martin tried to get it to Sittler. It's broken up. Here's the shot right on. Goes into the corner. Piling against the boards. Rosser goes after Salming. It's cleared by Juris. Up the center ice to Terry Martin. Martin leaves it there for Sittler, but he was checked. And the Vancouver team just shoot the puck down the ice over the blue line. Gradin couldn't control it. Picked up by Lanz. Lanz goes over here on the wing as its shot is fired wide by Brosser. Being hit was Stan Smeal. Now Juris. Clearing pass up to Sittler. His pass nowhere near Paymo. And the puck is picked up by Sittler. Over to Settleballer. And his shot was stopped by Hanlon. Sittler centered it up front. And now Canucks race down the ice. Schmatz getting it ahead. Here's the drive by Williams, and that was stopped by Rutherford. Williams goes after the puck. It's Williams getting a hold of it. Right in front of the net, a shot, and Rutherford stopped that from Bolduran. Back for Bruce Boudreau. He's poke checked by Bob Mano, and it's offside Settlebauer. From Maple Leaf Gardens in Toronto.
my friends and I are gonna find good times.
And when it's time for a beer, it's time for Canadian. There's a glass of Canadian.
To the good times.
Time for good times.
Yeah. Yeah.
Has scored for Vancouver. Pema for the Leafs. We're tied at 1, 17:08 to play, second period.
Boldarev facing off against Boudreau. Boudreau won the draw. Turnbull follows up, shoots the puck off the boards, handling out of the net, shoots it around the other side, but right to Settlebauer. Settlebauer couldn't center it. Williams goes back and recovers, goes back to the net. Hager Williams into the corner. Out in front of his own net. Lindgren getting it over. Up to center ice. Cleared by Boldarev. Goes into the corner. Settlebauer stopped by Schmatz. Schmatz goes to the other side. Vancouver with Boldarev. Passing it. Tipped by Settlebauer down the ice. Bob Mano goes back for it. Number two. Got there on the defense with Lindgren. Here's a quick pass to Schmatz. Schmatz shoots. Oh, and Jimmy Rutherford grabbed a hold of that one.
Schmatz stands over Rutherford as if to say, how in the world did you catch that? I like the way he cranks this one. Really leans into the shot, pulls the stick back and drills it at Rutherford. And a sensational glove stop by the Leaf netminder. Bobby Schmatz is a really handy guy to have in this Vancouver club. Along with a fellow like Williams, they have the experience, the leadership, and they bring the young fellas along, too, and that rubs off, especially in the dressing room. Great attitude.
Bit of repair work on the ice surface.
I was looking over the Leafs' goals against average before the game tonight. Bill, 2 years ago, they gave up 252 goals. They've allowed a league high of 327 last year, and they'll top that this season.
This is Toronto Maple Leaf Hockey live from Toronto.
Al Santing has put together one of the finest car service teams in the city, and he's very proud of his boys.
This is Al Santing. If you're not getting first-rate service for your repair dollar, it's time you discovered the Santing team. We do it all. Electronic engine tune-ups, alignments, steering and suspension, complete brake jobs, standard and custom exhaust. You name it, and we do it well.
Al Santing's Garage, Walker at EC Row.
Ladies, milling around after they had a face-off, play stopped, and I believe a penalty is going to be handed out. Fraser.
Kurt Fraser, who's a big, strong competitor for the Canucks, going to the box. Meanwhile, there's a lot of jousting going on in the face-off circle just, or the face-off spot just outside the Vancouver blue line. Now they break it up.
Vancouver penalty to number 24, Kurt Fraser. 2 minutes for cross-check. Time 3:59. Kurt Fraser for cross-check. Time 3:59.
Just the one penalty in that altercation. Fraser for cross-checking at 3:59. So Mike Nikoluk sends out his power play unit this time, comprising Derlego and Vive and Maloney up front. Watch for Maloney in front of Hamlin, Salming, and Turnbull at the points. He's going to be league president, that fellow.
All set for the faceoff, and Derlego and Miner are waved out. No, it's just Miner. Vive is going to take the faceoff for the Leafs. He wins the draw. And it's cleared, though, by Vancouver Miner down the ice. He's out there with Jerry Butler. Goes into Borja Salming. Salming. Cleared pass to Ian Turnbull. Turnbull to Salming. Salming moves up through center. A pass on the left wing for Dan Maloney. There's a race for it. Vancouver get to it first. That's icing. Play was made on the Leafs side.
Oh, there's a matchup near now. Harold the Hammer Snaps and Dan Maloney, number nine, additional penalties here now. Maloney and Snaps will probably go. Watch for Miner and Salming.
With the score, Vancouver 1 and Toronto 1. Our telecast returns in a moment.
The everything place for everyone's taste. The beautiful Devonshire Mall. Where Windsor folks meet, where they shop, where they eat. The beautiful Devonshire Mall.
It's Energy Conservation Week at Devonshire. Visit interesting displays and gather valuable information for energy conservation. Another community event from Devonshire.
Convenient Devonshire Mall.
Harold Snaps and Dan Maloney take roughing penalties here at 4:22. Still have a minute 37 to serve in the Curt Fraser penalty for cross-checking.
Puck grabbed out by Settlebauer, gets it out to center ice to Pimo. Pimo shoots the puck in, it goes around into the corner. Sittler goes after it, Miner's there with him, and they get a whistle.
A couple of years ago, Jerry Miner, number 20 in your picture now, was, well, he was in the minors, and pretty deep in the minors at that. They held his size against him, I believe. He had a good junior record, but he's come up and played splendidly for the Canucks, especially in a defensive role. Very good penalty killer.
The police have a man advantage. 6 men to 5. The puck goes from Settlebauer to Turnbull. Turnbull takes his shot. Hanlon stopped that. Knocked off the boards by McCarthy, but not out. Now it hit a skate, and it's driven out and down the ice. Back for it, Borya Salmi. Miner and Butler trying to keep the Leafs back in their own zone. Borya Salmi up on the left wing to Turnbull. Turnbull's over the line, stops. Shot it in to the side of the net, and it's cleared by Glenn Hanlon over the glass into the crowd.
Well, you see that Darryl Sittler's 4 points shy of Dave Keon's all-time scoring mark as a Leaf. He needs one more goal for another 35-goal season. That would be his eighth straight 35-goal year, the longest streak by an NHL player.
Turnbull let one fly wide. Paymon goes to the boards, but it's cleared down the ice. It goes to Turnbull. Ian Turnbull with Jerry Butler watching him. Salming finally gets the pass. Here comes the long shot. That's off the boards. Lindgren missed it. It's finally tipped out, and here's a 2-on-1. Miner going down with Gary Butler. Miner going right in, back to Butler. Oh, and Jimmy Rutherford slid out and made the save on Butler.
Jimmy Rutherford coming up with a big stop, and Jerry Miner, remember, he scored 4 shorthanded goals already this year, feeds a good pass over to Butler, but Rutherford was anticipating that pass. The play was perhaps just a shade slower than it might have been. And it gave Rutherford an opportunity to get over there. Miner, trying to do it perfectly, got the puck over, but Rutherford had time to recover. We may see it a little better from this angle as Miner comes in from the wing. You see him look up, see his teammate, the pass over, but Rutherford quickly moves over and blocks it.
Fraser has 15 seconds left in his penalty. 14-12 now remaining in the second period. We still have a 1-1 tie. Brosser getting it back. Now it goes to Schmeel. Schmeel clears it back. And it's out to Brosser for Schmeel. Covered by Hickey. And it's Bilderlego dropping it back for Farish. Then it was intercepted. Over the line for Brosser. It's in back of the net. Trying to get it out in front. That's Gradin, number 23. Does. There's the shot. Rutherford stopped that. Picard off the boards, and that was stopped by Lance. Now it's up to Hickey. To Derlego, hit the back of his skate. Vancouver putting on pressure. Goes over to Lance. Lance, nice stick handling, only to be poke checked by Bay Farish. Now it's Bob Mano. Up through center, over the blue line. Mano gets set for a screenshot. Oh, he just shot that one wide. goes for Lance at the blue line. He shoots it back in behind the net. Nordin tried to get to it, and it's picked off by Boudreaux. Got it out the center ice, couldn't reach Vibe with it, but it's offside at the Leaf blue line.
To the taste of life.
12:50 to play, tied at one. Those two first period goals, the only scoring thus far. Boldarev is 26, Paymaw is 31st. Tiger wanted a word with the coach, I believe.
Boldarev at center, Williams on the left side, and Schmatz on the right for Vancouver, facing Boudreaux, Saginac, and Anderson. They've been reunited in this second period. Boudreaux for John Anderson. Anderson was given a bump. They go to the boards. It's finally knocked back down the ice, and Melrose is there for the Leafs. Over for Turnbull. He missed it, and so did Boldarev. A long pass up to Rocky Saginac. Saginac to Anderson. Dropped it back to Turnbull. There's the shot, and he fired it wide. Goes into the corner. Saginac fighting for it. Goes loose. Coming out is Boudreaux right in front of the net. And Hanlon stopped that. Knocked down by the high stick. Play is called.
You have to admire Hanlon's goaltending, especially in those close-in shots. Take a look at the Molson Cup standings now. Overall for Toronto, Paymaw the leader with 50. Then Derlego, Vive, and Sittler all with 45. Salming with 40. And for Vancouver overall, Brodeur, the goaltender, with 90 points. 30 points ahead of Williams, then Smeal, McCarthy, and Brasser.
Huck in. McCarthy has it for Vancouver in their own territory. Playing with Lindgren. On the defense, Williams has given a bump. And up Boldarev tried to hit Bobby Schmatz. That's over the line, and that'll be icing. 11:51 remaining in this second period.
Turnbull has 110 goals as a Toronto Maple Leaf, a new club record. The NHL record for most goals by a defenseman held by Bobby Orr. Who else? 270.
Boudreaux getting set to face off. Boldarev wins the draw. McCarthy working his way out. A pass went down the ice. Weatherford clearing it around a Saginac. It gets tipped loose to Boldarev right in front. Oh, and that backhand by Schmatz just missed. And Bobby Schmatz has had some good chances in this hockey game so far. Schmatz shot it for Williams, way offside. This is NHL Hockey Live from Toronto.
Coulter Furniture. There is nothing like it from Windsor to Toronto. Imagine more than 60 sofa beds on display. Browse through 40 full bedroom suites. 110 sofas and sectionals in the latest fabrics. More than 40 elegant dining room suites. And countless designer accessory pieces. It takes a building complex almost a city block long to house and maintain the Coulter collection. If you're not shopping at Coulter's, you're just not shopping for furniture.
We'll soon be at the halfway mark of this hockey game, tied at one.
Darryl Sittler, Wilf Paymo, Harry Martin, Juris and Salming. Lupo out there, number 7 at center. Fraser on the left wing, number 24. And Ashton, 15, on the right side. And Ashton has the puck. Ashton gets it ahead to Lupo. Lupo took a hard shot, and that was wide. It comes loose. Now the Leafs have it. Center was checked. Here's a shot, and that was a drive by Fraser. Comes back to the blue line. Another screen shot hits the skate. Down went Salming, and the Leafs bring it back. Long pass for Paymo. Will Famo, he stole the puck. Bears it into the corner. Fraser has it, though, and Vancouver come out to Lupo. Lupo and Ashton come over the line together. Goes back to Fraser. Fraser into the corner. Now it's a pass out here on the right wing for Paymo. Paymo to Sittler. Sittler over on the wing. Martin tried to get it back. It's Sittler now centering it for Paymo. And that ends up on Fraser's stick. Fraser with a long shot. That's wide. Now Miner's out there for Vancouver. A shot by Lindgren, and it knocked out to center ice where Bill Derlego has it. Derlego comes over the line. It rolls, and Hanlon goes down and covers up. Nine minutes, 54 seconds remaining in the second period. Still a 1-1 tie.
Salmi made a very good play down the other end a moment ago. You can see how tired he is, but just a one-handed deflection of a shot with two Canucks around. This is where he took one off the leg or the ankle, and he was able to skate that one off.
Miner out there on the forward line at center. Butler and Rhoda on the wings. They didn't drop the puck fairly. We'll do it all over again. Derlego set the face off with Miner. Puck slides to the corner. Marcy Rota with the puck, number 18, tipped out and down the ice, and it's picked off by Picard. Picard over to Dan Maloney. Maloney to Derlego. Derlego just shoots the puck in. Rick Five goes after it. Rota's got him tied up. The puck finally is kicked loose. Derlego just failed to get a hold of it. And the Canucks just shoot the puck down the ice. Rota goes after it. Picard's first man back. Gets it to Farish, and his return to Maloney just fairly quick. Offside at the Vancouver blue line.
Oops, we have action here as Rota and Vive collide inside the Vancouver zone, inside the blue line. They'll go now.
Vive will get a high sticking penalty. Live from Maple Leaf Gardens in Toronto.
It takes calm, unhurried patience to brew Bredor, so take the time to appreciate it. From Molson. Take the time.
Vive gets the single penalty, a high sticking Miner at 10:40. So the Canucks have the man advantage out there. They're 14th in power play stats in the NHL, and penalty killing, the Leafs are 9th.
Dave Farish drops it back. Picard then to Boudreau, and he just shoots it down the ice. That's Kevin McCarthy working that puck up the center ice. Gets to the Leaf line, tried to clear it over out of the far wing. That's McCarthy again, getting it back to him. McCarthy finally shoots one, whatever stopped that. Back in the net is Boldarev. Williams standing in front. It comes back to the blue line. There's a shot that was stopped by Boudreau. Comes back to the blue line again, and finally it's knocked out and down the ice. McCarthy's back there for it. Grasser with him. It's out to Boldarev. Boldarev goes over the blue line. Boldarev trying to set it up with a screenshot. He did. Rutherford stopped that. Another stop, and they all pile there. They bang at it. Play is called. The referee's right there. There's no lights on.
underneath it, Al Rutherford is fishing for the puck, trying to keep it outside that goal line. I think he was able to do that. Farish coming in to lend some assistance, and the Canucks pushing hard to get it over. So here's how that pileup started. You can see the Tiger right in there, number 22. Farish is 23. The sticks come high. Boudreau takes his man out, and Rutherford is concentrating on that little black disc. .07 to play, second period. Rutherford getting a little breather here now after that hot action around him. He all but disappeared from sight there for a moment.
With 8 minutes and 7 seconds left to play in the second period, the score is Vancouver 1, Toronto 1.
Congratulations.
Is it your anniversary?
No, we just finished renovating our bathroom all by ourselves.
Looks great. You went to Plumbing Mart, didn't you?
Yeah.
Didn't Plumbing Mart give you some decorating tips and show you their great selection of bathroom fixtures and accessories?
Yeah.
And didn't they show you how to do it yourselves and save money?
Yeah.
Well, I guess you really didn't do it all by yourselves, did you?
No.
Plumbing Mart, connecting style and price with good advice.
We're going to have a face-off to the right of Jimmy Rutherford.
Mike Nicolek back of the Leaf bench there.
His record 10-9-5 since taking over as coach.
Here's Lanz with the puck. A back pass to Dusty Roto. Roto shoots, and he missed. Back to Schmatz. Schmatz then flipped it into the corner for Fraser. Fraser, number 24. Getting it back to Gradin, back to Fraser. Fraser shot it back to Schmatz. Schmatz goes over to Lanz. Back to Schmatz. Here comes the shot. Rutherford stopped that. Play is called. Rutherford mixing it up. A kick to go out of the traffic.
Pretty good penalty killing by the Leafs. They allowed the Canucks the corners. They let them control the puck in there. And that killed off some penalty time. We've got 11 seconds now left in the penalty to Rick Vive. Somebody lost a helmet there, and Sittler finally shoveled that out of the way as Rutherford went down to make that stop and grabbed it.
Seven minutes, 31 seconds remaining in the second period. 1-1 tie. 11 seconds left in Vive's penalty.
Saw Rota on your screen there a moment ago. He had only 15 goals last year. Has 20 so far this season.
Alice Gradin at center with Rota and Fraser on the wings. Mano was back at the blue line, so that's let one fly. And the rebound comes all the way to Paymon. Paymon goes straight down the ice, over the line. Trying to get around. He does. Took a shot across the goal mouth. Then a drive by Melrose hit the side of the net. Sittler for Vive, right in front of Paymon. His backhand was stopped, and the puck was shot up into the crowd.
That had them ducking, and now Vive, who did not go to the bench after his penalty time was served, went right into the play. And immediately he's involved with several other players, Sittler included, Melrose, Rota, and others again. They want to bunch up, and we could have something here tonight the way these fellas are playing.
Almost every whistle they get.
A lot of bristling. That black eye on Melrose.
Bill DeLego at center. John Anderson on the right side. Hickey on the left. Zelming and Juris on the defense. Attached to number 15 with Miner number 20.
lot of long delays on these line changes. Right now we have Ron Finn, the linesman. Well, he's just finished talking or conferring for some reason over at the Leaf bench. Away we go.
All set to go for this faceoff, and Hickey got too close. Then Anderson let his shot go. Harold Snipes has it. Snipes got it back. Knocked out to center, shot into the Leaf zone. Rutherford is out of the nets. Derligo tried to get his pass. It goes to the corner. And the Leafs with Salming to Derligo. A long pass tipped by Lars Lindgren. Lindgren gets it up to Miner. Miner shot it over here to number 15, Brent Ashton. And the Leafs recover and shoot it right back out the center ice. 6:29 is the time as Anderson takes out his check. The puck goes back into Vancouver territory. Snipes with it. Ahead to Ashton. Snipes was knocked down. Juris. Then lost it to Ashton to Miner. Miner closes in with a shot. Rutherford made the save on that. Looked in the net. And the Leafs shoot the puck down the ice as Juris was dumped into the Maple Leaf goal. Snipes touches it. Icing is called against the Toronto Maple Leafs.
Jerry Butler missed that puck by a fraction of an inch. Otherwise, the Canucks would lead by 2-1 instead of it being a 1-1 tie. Butler agonizing over that opportunity, lost now as the shot was stopped by Rutherford, but watch the rebound as Butler cruises through. Rutherford was looking back, and Butler almost found himself with a goal there. 6:01 to play, second period.
All the penalties are up. They're back at full strength. Mano left it there, and Boldrev's shot was stopped. It goes to the corner, comes back out. Boldrev trying to get around his check. It's a long pass out to center ice. Mano stopped that for Vancouver to Williams. Over the line with Schmatz. Schmatz tried to get it to Williams, a shot by Schmatz, and that's his third good try. It comes back. Schmatz has got it again, a shot. And Rutherford stopped that. Back up for Boudreaux. Over the line, offside was Saganak on the right wing.
Tiger Williams coming dangerously close again as the Canucks are pressing the Leafs and hemming them in their own zone now. Watch Williams, 22, the spin-around play off his foot or skate rather than his stick blade. Otherwise, Williams would have had one behind Rutherford. Rutherford very cool in there tonight and under a lot of pressure. Shots on goal in this period, 18-6 in favor of the Canucks. Well, they've certainly had the edge.
Verdeen gets it back to Snipes. Snipes got it over onto the far side, and now it's over the line for Vancouver. Rosser centered it out in front of the net. Shot to the blue line, kept in there by Rick Lands. Now it's right in front. There's a high shot by Smeal. Comes back to Lands. Lands centered it, and it's brought back by Melrose. Melrose was then checked. Back over the line for Gradin, and he lost it. Darryl Sittler for Paymo. And he couldn't get it to Remark. Now Ian Turnbull will try his luck. But he handed it over here to Gradin. Gradin going in with a shot. Score! Gradin got one through Jimmy Rutherford's legs.
Well, after stopping a lot more difficult shots than that one, the Canucks go in front 2-1, and they've had the pressure on, as we mentioned, all through this period. This one gets through the pads as the crowd is coming down hard on the Leafs now. The Leafs have been very frustrated. They haven't been able to clear the puck very well, and they've spent most of this period playing defensive hockey, frantically trying to get the puck out of danger. Radin scores, and it's 2-1 Canucks. We'll look at it from this angle, an unassisted goal right through the legs of Jimmy Rutherford. They have got his pads apart a second too soon on that one.
So Vancouver goes up 2-1 with 4:33 and counting in this second period. Now Miner with a long pass. Rota couldn't get to it. Derligo and Maloney. Now then Derligo shoots the puck into the corner. And the Leafs looking a little sloppy at this stage in the game. The puck comes out, and here comes Vancouver back again. Niners over the line, and his shot. Juris recovered. Juris slips it up to Vive. Vive just shoots the puck in, ends up in the corner. Cleared around by McCarthy, stopped by Vive, who was hit. Now it's knocked around the other side and out to center ice. Leafs turn at their own blue line. Juris to Selming. Up it comes to Boudreaux. Boudreaux to Vive. Vive over the line. There's his shot. He wrapped that one off the post. Here's the shot by Maloney. That was stopped. Another shot. Getting in front is Boudreaux, and he was stopped by Rota. Rota gets it out to center ice. We have 3 minutes, 20 seconds remaining in this, the second period. Here's a break. Jesse Rota gets a chance. Was hit. Spun around. Selming got back. And it goes to Saginac. Rocky Saginac. A pass ahead going in to Settlebauer, and he fanned on his shot. It's cleared out to center right. Williams giving it to Schmatz. Schmatz is over the line, let his shot go, and it was wide. Cleared to Boldarev. Boldarev then handed it back, and the Leafs get it out to center right. It's Rocky Saginac, and his back pass Boldarev has. Ivan Boldarev for Williams. Hager Williams was checked. Farish flips the puck to the blue line. Snaps kept it in. Goes back of the net. Picard up for Settlebauer. He stopped, but the puck is out. Now it's Schmatz getting in ahead to Boldarev. Boldarev going in. That's a shot that was stopped, and he missed with a second try. Bob Mano has it for Vancouver. He's back of the net. Coming out in front, and his backhand was wide. Boldarev over here to Snaps. There's the set. Score!
Right through the legs again, and it's 3-1 as the Vancouver Canucks completely dominate the Leafs for the past few minutes here on Garden's ice. 3-1 Canucks. Here's the scoring shot again, as they have kept control of that puck, especially in the Leafs zone. And the crowd very unhappy with the performance of the hometown Leafs as Steps gets goal number two. Boldarev helped set that one up. 18 minutes. 2 minutes to play, second period, as Harold Snaps fires his second goal of the year through the legs of Rutherford, who was playing well out of the crease.
So Vancouver with a 3-1 lead, and the Leafs shoot the puck into the Vancouver zone. Cleared into the corner. Sittler tried to center it. He missed it. Now it's Vancouver coming up. Rosser getting it over on the wing, and Smeal couldn't get loose. A long pass for Daryl Sittler over the red line. That's icing as it was touched. From Toronto, you are watching NHL Action Live.
Little Miss Muffin, where you get quality and quantity. Little Miss Muffin makes her muffins with delicious, wholesome ingredients daily, from the blueberries to the fresh buttermilk. At Little Miss Muffin, you can relax and enjoy a cup of fresh ground coffee and a muffin of your choice from 12 varieties, served hot if you wish. If you're heading to the office or home, you can stop for takeout service to please your staff or family. Little Miss Muffin now has two locations, east side, Eastgate Plaza, Tecumseh at Jefferson, and on the west side at Lambton Plaza, Grand Maris, and Huron Church Line.
Organist Ralph Fraser plays Oh Dear, What Can the Matter Be as the Leafs get ready for this faceoff.
They have the puck in the corner, pass out to Pimo. Pimo up at center ice, shot it over the line. Terry Martin didn't get to it. It was cleared by Smeal out to center ice. 1:22 left in the second period as Melrose shoots it in. Hanlon stopped it. Rick Lands getting it at Smeal. Smeal and Gradin going down with Lands. Here's right in front. And that was just missed. A pass for Terry Martin. Back at the blue line. And we have Lindgren getting the puck in. Rutherford knocked it to the corner. Picked up by Pimo. Pimo just shoots it out and down the ice. McCarthy stops it there. gets it up at center. Here they're over the line again. Jerry Butler took a shot. That was high over top of the net. Now Jerry Butler again just tried to get it to Rota. Snaps, covered Paymal. Right back. Here's a drive and a stop by Rutherford. And a swing by Turnbull puts it up in the crowd.
That was a spring training swing by Ian Turnbull. John Anderson will be a guest of Dave Hodge during the intermission. He may be in the uncomfortable position of trying to explain what is happening here to the Leafs in the second period. We'll also have a feature on hockey development throughout Ontario. 23 seconds away from our second intermission, it's been all Vancouver. 3-1, they lead it. 2 goals in this period.
And the faceoff. Leafs still to get the puck out. Darcy Roeder just couldn't make the pass. Leafs come back. Hickey over to Selming. He shot it wide. Cleared by McCarthy around on the boards. It stopped there. Shot right on by Juris. Now Derligo for John Anderson. It's shot to the blue line. There goes the bell. And the second period is over. And the Vancouver Canucks full value for their two-goal lead as they dominated almost all of that second period. So the score at the end of the second period, Vancouver 3, Toronto 1.
Get your tickets now for the World Cup.